It was at the start of September that Cathay Pacific cancelled flights following an in-flight failure of an engine component. The grounding of part of the Cathay fleet and urgent inspections undertaken by numerous airlines caused shares of the British engine maker to fall by as much as 6%. This was due to the fact that the A350 is exclusively powered by Rolls-Royce engines. Following the incident and reactions of operators, safety regulators put out an emergency airworthiness directive to have airlines around the world check their own A350-1000 engines. We haven't heard anything new about this issue for a while now, and so for today's video, let's take a look back at everything that has happened on this topic. Let's start at the beginning. According to Reuters, one of Cathay Pacific's flights, which had taken off from Hong Kong, suffered an in-flight failure on an engine component. The incident took place just after midnight local time on September 2nd, with flight CX-383 headed for Zurich. Shortly after the A350-1000, registered Bravo Lima X-ray India, took off and headed over the sea, it circled around twice before landing back at Hong Kong International Airport about 75 minutes later. As of the time of making this video, in late September, this airframe has yet to operate any subsequent flights. Reuters reported that Hong Kong's Air Accident Investigation Authority launched an investigation into the incident, which was the first of its kind worldwide. EASA noted days later that the event was classified as a serious incident and that an International Civil Aviation Organization, or ICAO, Annex 13 investigation was opened. Shortly after landing, Cathay decided to inspect its entire A350 fleet. Though details about the incident were not revealed at the time, Cathay said it contacted Airbus, Rolls-Royce, and its regulators immediately. Cathay Pacific shared the following statement with Simple Flying shortly after the diversion incident took place. Each aircraft is undergoing a rigorous inspection. Upon completion, the aircraft cleared for operation will return to service, while those identified with technical issues will undergo further repair and maintenance work. Meanwhile, we are liaising with the Hong Kong Civil Aviation Department and the aircraft and engine manufacturers. In its inspection process, Cathay found a number of the same engine components that needed to be replaced. Per reporting from various sources, 15 of the airline's A350s were discovered to have related issues. The airline at the time said that spare parts had already been sourced and that replacement work had already begun. It was also notable that proper maintenance could be conducted whilst the engine was on wing, allowing far quicker inspections and fixes for impacted airlines. The European Union Safety Agency, EASA, commented on the incident shortly after it took place, saying, "We will be monitoring any information coming out of the technical investigation and will take decisions on any fleet-level action as required." Prior to any official airworthiness directive being issued, operators of the Airbus A350 decided to be proactive and inspect their aircraft, regardless of the variant. Singapore Airlines announced that it would inspect all the engines powering its fleet of 64 A350-900 aircraft as a precautionary measure, despite the variant using a different engine than what powers the A350-1000. Japan Airlines also opted to check its A350 fleet, focusing on its 5 A350-1000s, but also carrying out voluntary inspections of its Dash 900s as a precaution. As reported by the South China Morning Post, the Japanese carrier found no problems with its aircraft. Air China performed general engine checks, while Thai Airways said its technicians would review the situation and make engine checks regularly. According to media outlet The National, Qatar Airways said on September 3rd, "At present, there has been no impact on the operation of any Qatar Airways Airbus A350-1000s. We are continuing to monitor any developments." And so, it was a few days later, on September 5th, that EASA officially mandated inspections on the global Airbus A350-1000 fleet, powered by Rolls-Royce Trent XWB-97 engines. This was said to be a, quote, "precautionary measure following a serious incident concerning a Cathay Pacific flight from Hong Kong." The regulator issued Emergency Airworthiness Directive 2024-0174-E, mandating that airlines conduct a phased, one-off inspection of flexible fuel hose connections inside the engines to check for damage. The day the EASA statement was put out on September 5th, it stated that inspections needed to take place over the next 3 to 30 days, depending on the individual engine history. Examining the directive, it states that aircraft needing inspection within 3 days were those with engines having accumulated 18,500 engine hours or more since new and had 2 or more previous shop visits, whether they be hospital, check and repair, refurbishment or overhaul. The 3-day compliance time also applied to engines having accumulated 2,300 engine cycles or more since new. More generous compliance times were assigned to engines that had not yet reached the specified number of engine hours or cycles or hadn't yet undergone any shop visits. The regulator added that, in total, 86 A350-1000 aircraft are in service worldwide. EASA also provided more detail on the Cathay Pacific incident, saying that an in-flight engine fire took place shortly after takeoff. The fire was promptly detected and extinguished. Pilots performed a commanded in-flight shutdown of the engine and the aircraft returned safely to Hong Kong. It was labelled as a controlled temporary engine fire, which resulted in heat damage to the exterior and interior of the engine nacelle, or thrust reverser C ducts. While A350 operators around the world were quick to respond to the news, so were investors. News of the incident on September 2nd spread quickly, leading to shareholders of Rolls-Royce to dump their stock as they anticipated that this would be a costly issue for the company. The company's share price dropped from about £496 to £464 after news of the incident. While the company's stock price recovered slightly in the days following the incident, there was another notable drop after the issuance of EASA's airworthiness directive. At the time of making this video, however, the stock price has essentially recovered, which in retrospect could have offered a good bargain for optimistic investors. By now, about 3 weeks after the incident has taken place, we thought we would have heard more from Rolls-Royce. The company did issue a statement on September 3rd promising to support airlines, but no further details have come from the company. Perhaps EASA's airworthiness directive stated everything relevant to the problem, with nothing more needed to be said, even by Rolls-Royce. And then, just as we were about to wrap up this video, Hong Kong's Air Accident Investigation Authority, or AAIA, issued a preliminary report, offering more insight into the problem that started it all. The report noted that during the post-flight examination, it was discovered that the steel-braided sheath of the fuel hose, namely the secondary fuel manifold hose connected to the number 17 fuel spray nozzle, was ruptured, as evidenced by a hole in the hose. 5 additional secondary fuel manifold hoses also had either frayed metal braids or collapsed structures inside the hose, according to the AAIA. Inspections also revealed that fuel that was directed to the fuel spray nozzle could leak through the ruptured secondary manifold hose, and with contributing factors such as the presence of oxygen and an ignition source, such as heat, this could have resulted in a fire that could have spread to the surrounding area. And so, that's everything that has thus far taken place related to the Cathay Pacific A350-1000 engine fire incident. Looking back at everything that has happened, the Hong Kong carrier acted swiftly to ground and inspect its fleet, while alerting regulators and other relevant airlines of the issue. Considering the fact that Airbus A350-1000s are deployed on some long flights over water, it's good news that the trigger incident took place relatively close to home and that nothing disastrous took place as a result. So, what do you think about the small and sudden A350-1000/Trent XWB-97 crisis that airlines faced at the start of September? Do you think it was well handled? Share your thoughts by leaving a comment. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.